So many of us are sitting here. IAS, yesterday I met. I was posing the same question to the IAS officers. Now I'm asking you. So many of us officers are sitting here. IAS, IPS, civil servants, government, secretaries, highest level bodies, ministers, including the chief minister himself. All of us are sitting here. Very well knowing that this building is an illegal building. Very well knowing that this building where we sit in, where we're sitting in, has breached every violation. Letter written by the department quoting the rules. Irrigation department quoting the rules. The road on which we traveled, the bund level, the maximum flood level of the flood level is 22.6. The area where we are sitting is at 19.6 meters. River Conservation Act breached, Lokayukta judgments breached, Green Tribunal judgments breached, Master Plan breached, Building Bylaws breached. In front of our eyes, ikkade Manakella Yadutane, CM Gare, illegal building lo unter. Pakane. Maji CM Gare. Whatever it is, even if CM, even if I do it, it's still wrong. Doesn't make a difference. We are in positions of authority. Does it justify? Because I am a CM, because you are an SP, because you are a collector, you can do it. We can't. How does it justify a CM staying in an illegal house, illegal property, illegal building? Pakane ikkade, the government itself constructs an illegal building. And then what happened? Because CM himself is living in an illegal building, because the government itself constructs an illegal building, what happens? You see this entire road. Everywhere you have illegal buildings coming up. Nobody to stop. Nobody to stop. Right in front of our eyes. See this entire road. What are we doing? Is this good governance? Best practices? I ask all of you to think. Alochinjeyamani adugutha unna. When we are in power, when we are in position of strength, it comes with responsibility. We need to live by an example. We need to set certain standards in place. And when we drop, do we have any moral right or authority to even question anybody else? We need to ask ourselves this basic question. That is why I say to all of you sitting down here, I say no to corruption, say no to looting, say no to illegal activities. And to clean up the system, to bring about a change into the system, to set a standard in place. Yesterday I gave a call I said, I'm holding this meeting just to showcase this. But this is not how one should be. This is not what we are. This is not good governance. And yesterday I said, let's start the demolition from here in this, from this building. Today I'm asking you the same thing. Starting tomorrow, this building will be the first building to be demolished. Because we want to send a signal. We want to send a message. Once we start here, this entire road will be cleansed. It just doesn't stop here. I want you to take up this exercise in the districts as well. Send a message to the collectors as well as to the SPs. I speak to both of you. Show them that, you know, we are different. Show them henceforth, what has happened is happened. Henceforth, this government will bring about a change. We are not going to keep quiet if sand is outrightly looted. We are not going to keep quiet. Send a message. If illegal mining takes place, send a message. We are not going to keep quiet. If somebody forces people to give money, even if it means our MLAs, it doesn't make any difference. Send a message, we are not going to keep quiet. Send a message against illegal activities. Anything to do with illegality, send a message. Anything to do with corruption, send a message. Anything to do with looting, send a message. Only then we bring about best practices. Only then we can talk about number one policy. Only then we can talk about good governance. It requires a strong will. And I'm saying you, and I'm saying to you, that I'm with you. I'm with you. Anything you do it in this purview, my blessings are totally with you. I'm totally in support of you. Bring about a change. Let this system change.